exclusively from Indisputable. Here's the video of what appears to be a police officer stealing money from a bank robber. Here it is. Let me put up the screenshot of another officer while he looked to be attacking the individual accused of robbing a bank. Indisputable has obtained an amended report from July 9th, 2021, over a year after the bank robbery, which happened March 9th, 2020, that adds significant details to the initial report. Sources say the additions were made after local news became interested in the BB&T bank robbery in Riverdale, Georgia. In the exclusive video, you can see that man right there, that is Lieutenant Kirby Threat, now Captain Threat. He looks to be punching a black suspect who was already subdued. That's one element of this case. Now, how did we get this video? Well, the video was basically a Ring video doorbell. These officers were unaware that this video existed until we broke the story. Now, in the amended report, let's put up the second graphic. In the amended report, it does not mention the use of force. That's required, by the way. It does not mention use of force or include the Ring video doorbell that we obtained. Well, damn, look at that. We're better investigators than them. Meanwhile, the second officer, Victor Ortega, who we misnamed Vincent in yesterday's broadcast, his name is Victor. He walks away from the suspect to collect the cash off the ground. You clearly see that in the video. Bank robbery, hot pursuit, he collects the cash off the ground. What? Why are you picking up the money? I know some would say, well, he must have been organizing the money. Okay, stick with that, and I got something else for you. A police officer who spoke to us on the condition of anonymity said, and I quote, the evidence should have never been touched from the ground. If you catch a robber in hot pursuit, that means the money should all be there. Not everything was recovered. Every penny should have been accounted for in evidence, according to a current police officer with the Riverdale PD. You know why he has to speak under the condition of anonymity? Because he's scared of the police. I am not. Let's put up the report. We have the leaked report now. Let me tell you what you're looking at. The leaked report shows about $1,800 was taken into police custody. Remember that number, about 1,800. At the moment, we are trying to verify from our sources how much money was actually allegedly stolen by the suspect to determine what could have been allegedly pocketed by Officer Ortega. We do not have all of those facts in evidence yet, but we are looking. The reality is, the police report initially did not have this information on it, and they were allowed to amend the police report a year later. You mean to tell me you know more details a year later than you did on the day of? Also, only one police report existed from that day, only one, and it was from Ortega, the man you see on the video. That's according to the information we have received. Let's go ahead and put him up. The chief and the mayor Now, I'm including the mayor now because they have refused to return the emails of my production team. Chief Todd Spivey, chief of police, and Mayor Evelyn Dixon have not responded to requests or comment about the allegations made by our sources connected to their police department. But it is worth noting that city council actually canceled their scheduled meeting yesterday. All right. Now, why is this so important to you? Why should you be concerned about this? Because corruption does not exist in a vacuum. If this is true, that means it is systemic. That means individuals were protected. That means that people who engaged in malfeasance received promotions rather than penalty. That's what it means. It's important to you because corruption is never linear. It always has variables. If they'll steal, they'll do other things too. You know, my grandmother used to say, if you lie, you'll steal. And if you steal, you'll kill. Come on, Rickey. Your mama told you the same thing.
You know.
So what are your thoughts on this, brother?
Well, that's why I don't fool with liars, because I really believe that. And we both have grandma backgrounds, and I have to say the Justice Department, the United States Justice Department, should be really, really busy these days investigating stuff like this, because it seems like the police who's supposed to be policing can't police themselves. Mm-hmm. And you can't hold other people accountable if you can't hold yourself accountable. And integrity starts within and it works its way out. I think it's a sad day for the police officers to not only assault the black man, but to steal money. And thank God for cell phone and ring cameras, which is a part of solving a lot of crimes, because now you got that third eye watching you. And like you said, people just have to, we have to get back to integrity and holding people accountable, but they have to hold themselves accountable. And I hope that they are fired. I hope that the police chief is held accountable from the mayor's office on down or whatever, because they have to stop playing politics and do what's right, whether you're Democrat or Republican or whatever. Right is right and wrong is wrong. And they should all be fired, especially the way that they are. And I find it interesting that the Fraternal Order of Police, you never hear a peep from them whenever you hear about cases like this or whatever. But everything is always Blue Lives Matter. But when it comes to something like this or assaulting a person of color, you never hear from the Fraternal Order of Police.
Never, not a peep at all.